roll call on any vote that is taken today. And that includes roll call for attendance and roll call for the adjournment. For attendance, you will say present. And for any other votes, you will say yes or no. Everyone can hear each other, including the remote participants. Is everybody clear with that? And I think Dave's done a good job of having that done. Names of the members who are participating notably will be announced as roll call is taken. That will be everyone. At this time, we will start with the roll call. This is the Cape Cod Commission meeting for Thursday, April 16th, 2020. And the time right now is 3:03 after those announcements. So at this time, I'll ask Lisa to please take the roll call vote and for Dave to unmute each member for the screen.
Welcome to Zoom. Enter your meeting ID followed by pound.
You read?
Yeah, I don't know who that is.
Okay, Fred Charagotas.
Enter your participant ID followed by pound. Otherwise.
Fred Charagotas.
How about here? Can you hear me?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Stephen Mealy.
Here.
Elizabeth Taylor.
Present.
Tom Wilson.
Here.
Richard Roy.
Here.
Joy Brookshire.
Present.
Charles McCaffrey.
Present.
Jacqueline Etston. Ernie Vigilio. Len Short. Cheryl Andrews.
Present.
Harold Mitchell.
Present.
Kevin Grunwald.
Present.
Richard Elkin.
Present.
John McCormick. Ron Bergstrom. John Harris.
Present.
David Whedon.
Present.
Michael Maxim.
Present.
Thank you. We have a quorum.
Thank you very much. If any members come into the meeting afterwards, we'll announce that they're here so they can be counted on further votes. At this time, we'll look at the minutes for March 5th, 2020. Everyone received these minutes during their email, through their email. If there's no changes or corrections, I will take a motion to accept the minutes as written.
So moved.
Thank you, Elizabeth. And may I have a second?
Second.
Thank you. Is that Joyce?
Yes.
Thank you, Joyce. I appreciate that. All right, at this time, we'll take a roll call vote for the minutes of March 5th, 2020, and please answer yes or no or abstention. Go ahead, Lisa, and thank you. And Dave, if you can turn on the mics.
Fred Charagotas?
Yes.
Stephen Mealy?
Yes.
Elizabeth Taylor?
Yes.
Tom Wilson.
Yes.
Richard Roy.
Yes.
Joy Brookshire.
Yes.
Charles McCaffrey.
Yes.
Jacqueline Etston. Ernest Vigilio. I know Ernie was present. I don't know if he's able to get in. Len Short. Cheryl Andrews.
Yes.
Harold Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Grunwald.
Abstain.
Richard Elkin.
Yes.
John McCormick Jr.
Yes.
John Harris.
Abstain.
David Whedon. David Whedon? We have Michael Maxim.
Abstain.
And I'll try David Whedon one more time.
And also Ernie.
Yes.
And Jackie. Can you hear me?
Yes. Thank you, Jackie.
I'm here and I voted yes.
Thank you. There were 14 yes votes, 3 abstentions. The motion carries.
Thank you very much. At this time, we'll have our executive director's report, I'm sorry, from Christy.
Good afternoon. Can everybody hear me okay? Maybe just nod. Yeah, okay, good, great. It's very nice to see all of you, even though remotely. Our staff has been working remotely since March 16th due to Governor Baker's stay-at-home advisory due to the COVID-19 pandemic, as you're all aware. I've been participating on twice weekly phone calls with the department managers of the county, as well as participating in weekly Barnstable County Regional Emergency Planning Committee conference calls and trying to provide enough information to the community about this pandemic. We have, in partnership with Cape Cod Healthcare and the Barnstable County Department of Health and Environment, developed an online community alert heat map system showing the number of new confirmed cases within Barnstable County. So this is available on the COVID resources page on our website. And if you haven't taken a look at it yet, I'd encourage you to do that. You're probably all aware of this by now, but I had started a tour of the boards of selectmen, and I did fortunately visit a handful of towns. That tour has been put on hold until further notice, and certainly would love to be able to participate in those meetings in person. So to the extent that's going to be possible in the next few months, I'll try to do that. Otherwise, those may end up as virtual meetings as well. And we'll certainly notify you as the members and would love your attendance, even if it is virtually. We are holding a lot of our meetings virtually now, and the MPO, the Metropolitan Planning Organization, was the first committee to meet virtually back in March on the 23rd, and they did quite well. We had the Greenhouse Gas Emissions Review Committee meet on their methodology in early April. And then last week we held virtually a Barnstable County Economic Development Council meeting. We're also convening the subcommittee of the Water Protection Fund as they develop regulations to support the distribution of those funds. And so, and then just lastly, we sent around a press release yesterday. We were notified by the Department of Commerce earlier this week that we've been awarded a $1 million grant from the Federal Economic Development Administration to support some of our resiliency planning efforts in the region. And we're extremely pleased to see that support coming from the federal government. We've been working on this application since the fall. I think September was the date that we started having conversations with the staff at the Federal Economic Development Administration. So we're pleased to see that support for resiliency initiatives, not only environmental, but economic resiliency, which has got a whole new meaning now. So, and then lastly, Gail and I attended a virtual meeting of the Barnstable County Assembly of Delegates yesterday, and we were discussing our FY21 budget. We also delivered amendments to Chapter A that you approved last month, and so the Assembly will schedule a hearing to consider that ordinance within the next coming weeks and months. Quick staff update. Dave Sullivan, as you know, who was one of our staff working in a lot of our IT programs, but working closely with the communities on some of our online applications and electronic permitting, has decided to leave the commission and has taken another job. And so we want to thank him for his efforts and thank him for his service to the commission and to the region and wish him well. And his last day is going to be Friday, tomorrow. And then we also hired a new community design planner, and she was supposed to start at the end of this month. It's been delayed. Her start's been delayed a little bit due to the current health emergency, but we look forward to getting her on board hopefully sooner rather than later. So thank you for your time. And as always, if you have any specific questions, feel free to reach out to me directly at any point. So I'll hand it back over to the chair. Thank you.
Thank you, Christy. Appreciate it. So now we'll move forward to the only item on our agenda for today. Pursuant to Governor Baker's executive order suspending certain provisions of the open meeting law dated March 12, 2020, the Cape Cod Commission will hold a continued the public hearing on the following development of regional impact, which is the DRI exemption request, originally scheduled for Thursday, April 2nd, 2020, but now on Thursday, April 16th, 2020 at 3 o'clock. The commission will consider and decide whether to approve the DRI exemption request and adopt a draft written DRI exemption decision for the project pursuant to Section 12K of the Cape Cod Commission Act as amended. The project is CCYCWCT Land Division, commission file number 20046. Project's applicants is Chesequit Yacht and Country Club Trust and Wellfleet Conservation Trust. Project location is 680 Chesequit Neck, Wellfleet, Mass. 02667. The project description is proposed land division of the property of the Yacht and Country Club property for the primary purpose of conveying land to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. The applicant will now do their presentation, and I believe that will be Liza Cox. Anyone here to do the presentation for the applicant?
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
You also have public comment on the agenda. I don't know if you want to take it up now or if you want to wait until after this agenda item.
I'll take it after this agenda item, but thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Can you hear me, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, Liza. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for having this hearing today. This is the first time I've done one of these remote hearings, so if you have any suggestions or questions, I'll do my best to try and respond during the course of the presentation. I'm here this afternoon on behalf of the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust, which is one of the co-applicants in this petition. Joining me as a participant on the call is Barbara Boone, who's the general manager of the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club. And also participating, who I'll introduce to speak in a few moments, is Dennis O'Connell, who's the president of the Wellfleet Conservation Trust, which is, as I mentioned, the co-applicant in this petition. I'm going to try and put up the graphics. There's a couple of three slides. Maybe Mallory can help me. There we go. So this is the first slide. The Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust owns about 105 acres on the north and east sides of Chequesset Neck Road in Wellfleet. This aerial shows generally the property. If you're familiar with it, the main clubhouse is, if you can see my cursor right, it's sort of in the middle bottom of the screen. And obviously you can see the golf courses along the side. The ocean is on sort of the bottom of the screen, the south of the screen. And then as you wind around Chequesset Neck Road, this land also abuts the Herring River. I know many of you are familiar with this location sitting on the Herring River Restoration Project, which is also currently undergoing Cape Cod Commission review. This land is home to the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club, which is a very important asset within the town of Wellfleet. It offers recreational and educational opportunities to people of all ages, from seniors to its summer kids camp. If I could have the next graphic up. Thank you. Again, this is a little bit hard to see, but The this petition is seeking a proposed division of the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust property. The property presently consists of multiple parcels of land, and the portion of the property that's being impacted by this division is shown as lot 57 on a land court plan and on assessor's map at 19 as parcel 81. It contains about 70 acres of the approximately 105 acres that's owned by the trust. As is shown on this graphic, and again, I apologize, it's a little bit hard to see, but hopefully you all have it in your application packages as well. The trust is proposing to divide this parcel to create three lots, which are shown on this proposed A&R division plan. These lots consist of lot 85, which will contain approximately 50.17 acres. That lot will continue to be owned by the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust and used by the club. Lot 83, which is the second largest lot that's proposed of this division, consists of about 18.31 acres of land. It abuts both Chequesset Neck Road and the Herring River. And this parcel is ultimately proposed to be conveyed to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. And then finally, lot 84, which is a proposed panhandle lot consisting of about 1.69 acres of land, which is proposed to be conveyed and then subjected to a conservation restriction. My client, the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust, has entered into a purchase and sale agreement with a third party, whereby that third party will purchase lots 83 and 84. Following that conveyance, lot 83, the larger of the two lots to be conveyed, will be gifted to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust, which will hold the land for open space and conservation purposes. The fee in lot 84, which is the smaller panhandle lot, will be retained by the third-party buyer to provide a buffer between her existing home and the abutting land, and a conservation restriction is proposed on that lot 84, which will be held by the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. We have reviewed the draft decision that was prepared by commission staff and concur with the decision that this proposed land division does not have any significant regional impacts and therefore is eligible for a so-called Section 12K exemption. This division is being done for land conveyancing purposes only. No construction is proposed with this application. The proposed division and resulting conveyances will result in the permanent conservation of over 18 acres of land with the conveyance to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust that has ecological value and sensitivity. It directly abuts the Herring River and also land that's owned by the National Seashore. At over 18 acres of land, lot 83 will be one of the largest conservation parcels that's owned by the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. The proposed division and conveyances also advance the purposes of the Cape Cod Commission Act, which include furthering conservation and preservation of undeveloped areas, wildlife, flora, and habitats, together with the protection of groundwater, surface water, and ocean water quality. And so while DRI jurisdiction is triggered by the overall acreage involved, we suggest that a DRI exemption is warranted here, as this division does not have any significant regional impacts outside the town of Wellfleet. At this point, I'd like to introduce Dennis O'Connell, who's the president of the Wellfleet Conservation Trust, one of the co-applicants in this petition, to say a few words. After he speaks, I'm certainly happy to try and answer any questions that the commissioners may have. Quickly, though, before I turn it over to Denny, I wanted to say a quick thanks to your staff, John Eidman, for all of his assistance, but also especially to Lisa Dillon and David Still for all of their assistance in helping me get ready for this remote hearing. And actually, I have one more graphic maybe that I'd asked the last graphic to be posted. This shows a blow up of the land, an aerial of the land, and you can see where the bridge is, where it crosses the Herring River. This is sort of an aerial of the land that would be involved in this division and ultimately owned most of the 18 acres of it by the Wellfleet Conservation Trust for open space purposes. So I thought this was a useful graphic in visualizing the land that's involved. With that, I'll turn it over to Denny to say a few words, and again, happy to answer any questions thereafter.
Am I active?
Yes, you are.
Okay, thank you. Well, thank you, Liza. Needless to say, the Wellfleet Conservation Trust is very excited about this project and very thankful for the donor who is working in between Chequesset Yacht and Country Club and ourselves. The Wellfleet Conservation Trust is a standard local land trust. We are 501c3 and maintain all our good standings. We have over 100 parcels of land in town for a total of 380 acres, more or less. So this is really quite exciting for us. It's all beautiful upland and will be preserved as is. Liza, is there anything else I should be saying here?
That's great.
I guess the other comment is with regard to the CR, we have an understanding with the owner, and we will place a CR on that lot. The CR process, as many of you probably know, is a rather lengthy one with all the steps and all that, but there's no reason this shouldn't be approved, and so we'll plan to get that done.
Right. Thank you, sir. Liza, does that conclude your presentation?
Thank you. Yes, it does.
Thank you very much. At this time, we'll move to the staff presentation by John Eidman.
Good afternoon, everybody, Mr. Chair, members of the commission. The reason this project is before the commission is the land in the aggregate is contiguous and it's over 30 acres in size, and there's a proposed division or subdivision of the land. That's a categorical DRI threshold. However, within the Act, there's the opportunity for an applicant who's otherwise subject to DRI review to apply for a DRI exemption. And the standard for granting a DRI exemption is basically given the nature, location, or effects associated with a particular proposal. Those characteristics prevent that particular proposed development from having substantial impacts on those interests that are cited in Section 1 of the Act outside the town in which the proposed development is located. So after reviewing this, staff felt first that the circumstances involved in the case presented a relatively typical or standard fact pattern similar to prior cases where the commission had granted DRI exemption relief, and that the proposed development here itself, which is merely land division without any construction involved, met the criteria for a DRI exemption in the Act that I just went over with you. Though it is outside the particular criteria for the granting of a DRI exemption, there's also, I think, another perspective to consider here. Even if the commission isn't necessarily looking at consistency with the regional policy plan as part of the DRI exemption, it's kind of an important perspective to maybe consider as a side note, which there are some really important natural resources and community character resources associated with this piece of land. And the proposed development, which is really a division and then a preservation of the land, also substantially forwards a number of different interests under the Commission Act and the policy plan associated with natural resource protection, the protection of community character, and open space protection. Much of what I have said, all of what I've said, is reduced to a draft written decision, which has been distributed to you, reviewed with the applicant. And so that decision contains all the findings necessary to grant a DRI exemption. There are a few conditions in that decision as well. Basically, we want to ensure that the land, that 18 acres, is ultimately deeded and donated into the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. That is the primary condition in the decision. We'd also like to see the final recorded copy of the approval not required division plan. Those are conditions in the decision. Simply with that, I'd be happy to take any questions today as they arise. Thank you.
Thank you. At that time, do we have any of the original opening for questions? I see Elizabeth would like to ask a question.
Oh, I just want to say thank you for the presentation from everyone. And I wholeheartedly support this application and I'm always thrilled to see land put into protection as open space, and especially since this is abutting the Herring River. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other members of the commission for the initial round have any questions or comments? Seeing none.
Hi, Harold, David Wheaton here.
Yes, David.
I just want to be clear. With the subdivision, there was three parcels and one was going to a group that's not a conservation trust. Was that, did I hear that correctly?
This is John. That's correct, David. There's a approximately a 1.5 acre parcel that will remain with this third party you heard, this current owner of land out there, who is really who will ultimately be the donee who's facilitating the purchase of this land. She will retain about a 1 acre, 1.5 acre parcel of land to append to her existing land. That will ultimately be put under a conservation restriction. I didn't address that as specifically in the decision because honestly, it's at least staff's position that doesn't have as much regional significance as this 18 acre parcel that's being identified to be divided as one of the parcels and then deeded and donated over to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. But you're correct, there are actually three parcels. There's like a small parcel, 1.5 acres, 18 acres that'll ultimately go to the Wellfleet Conservation Trust. And the quote remainder parcel is about 50 acres and that remains with the Chequesset Yacht and Country Club Trust.
Okay. Any other commissioners have any question or comments for the first round of questions? Seeing none, I will close off the first round of questions. I'm gonna open up now for public comment on the DRI exemption. I'm gonna just repeat the way of the process of this. If anyone wishes to speak, for those online, to click on the participants box on the bottom of the screen and then click raise hand in the text box. For those who called in by telephone, you can press *9. I'll recognize you by name or by telephone number when it's time to speak. If anyone's having any technical issues, you can either use the chat box on your screen or call 508-362-3828 and staff will assist you. At this time, I'll start with any public officials, state or federal public officials, or town officials that would like to speak. I'm going to go up and down the list and just be careful. And we also have Jordan is also helping me with this. I don't see any, so I will move forward. Any members of the public that would like to speak to this, now would be the time. Hit the raise your hand box and we would recognize you for you to speak on this project. Just going up and down just to make sure there's no one. Seeing none, one last time, I'll close off public comment for the project. And at this time, I will ask for the commissioners for a last round of any questions or comments that they may have. Ask you to raise your hand if you'd like to speak and I'll recognize you for that comment. Anyone at this time? I see none, so we'll move forward. At this time, I'll ask for a motion to adopt the draft written decision approved by the DRI exemption request of the Quesset Yacht and Country Club Trust and the Wellfleet Conservation.
I'm gonna, so moved.
I'm gonna, okay, who was that, please?
Dick Elkin.
Thank you, Dick. And do I have a second, please?
Second.
Elizabeth?
Yes. Do you have a question or are you giving me a second, Elizabeth?
No, I was giving you a second.
Thank you very much. So I have a motion and a second. What we're going to do now is we're going to open up the, do a roll call vote. Lisa will do the roll call vote. And I'll ask that all the mics be unmuted so we can do the roll call vote, please. And Lisa, if you'd like to do the roll call vote, please.
Fred Chiragotis?
Yes.
Stephen Mealy?
Yes.
Elizabeth Taylor?
Yes.
Tom Wilson?
Yes.
Richard Roy?
Yes.
Joy Brookshire?
Yes.
Charles McCaffrey?
Yes.
Jacqueline Etston?
Yes.
Ernest Virgilio?
Yes.
Len Short? Absent. Cheryl Andrews?
Yes.
Harold Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Grunwald?
Yes.
Richard Elkin?
Yes.
John McCormick Jr.?
Yes.
John Harris?
Yes.
David Whedon? David Whedon?
Yes.
And Michael Maxim?
Yes.
So the motion passes with 16 votes. We thank you for that. At this time earlier, I missed public comment, so I will open up the forum for public comment from anyone that may like to speak. Once again, as I've said, those that want to speak on the public comments, you just go to the participation box and raise your hand. I will look for those public comments now if anyone would like to speak on any item. I'm seeing none. So we will move forward. At this time, any new business topics or anything that anyone has to bring before the commission? Seeing none, I will take a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, who was the motion made by, please?
John McCormick.
Thank you, Jack, appreciate it. So at this time, we'll take a vote by Lisa for the adjournment.
Fred Chiragotis?
Yes.
Stephen Mealy?
Yes.
Elizabeth Taylor?
Yes.
Tom Wilson?
Yes.
Richard Roy?
Yes.
Joy Brookshire?
Yes.
Charles McCaffrey?
Yes.
Jacqueline Etston? Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Chris Virgilio.
Yes.
Len Short. Cheryl Andrews.
Yes.
Yes.
Kevin Grunwald.
Yes.
Richard Elkin.
Yes.
John McCormick Jr.
Yes.
John Harris.
Yes.
David Whedon.
Yes.
And Michael Maxim.
Yes.
Thank you. I would like to thank everyone for participating today. We appreciate everyone's participation and their patience as we work through this process. I hope everyone's family is safe and happy. And we'll be sending out emails and instructions on how our next meeting will be, what will be going forward. So please, everyone, stay safe and happy, and we'll talk to you later. Thank you very much.